Hi, welcome to another video. For this week, we're doing a quick sculpt. You've seen the thumbnail by now, so you know what we're doing. So it's like a kind of a cat alien creature kind of thing. And this started like very unintentionally. It all started with a sphere, as usual. And I was just like sculpting the regular shape of a generic alien. You know, like big eyes, small nose, tiny mouth, big skull. And this was just like the direction that I went for. Here I'm just extracting the neck from the head shape, and I tried to create like a bust, defined a few of the main muscles. Here I'm sculpting the neck. And the way that I do this is just like using the what's it called, these adaptive subdivision, or the, yeah, something like that's called, quad subdivision, I can't remember, sorry about that. Yeah, so then I created the eyes. I just created a sphere and I mirrored it to the other side, and I kept sculpting. So this one was a very fun one for me, because this is the first time that I tried to better sculpt the eyes. All the area around the eyes, all the structure, the bone structure, the lids. I tried this new technique of creating another sphere, or actually duplicating the same sphere and then just like scaling it, subdividing it, and then just like extracting or carving the shape of the eyes out of that new shape, and then just like refine it using it different brushes after. And I think this was like one of my best attempts at like sculpting eyelids, and yeah, in general the nose came out pretty nice too, because of the holes. Came out really nice, I think. And yeah, it's then once you have like a good base, it's like a good idea to change the matcap, at least for me. Something that I do quite often if I feel that I don't have a nice matcap that is showing the form. Probably I just like try to find another one. I downloaded a few ones from all over the internet. Probably you can just like Google a few, and Blender comes with a few very nice ones, especially these like brown clay. It's very, very good to really show the shape and the crevices of the sculpt. So here I increased the subdivision level to start like adding secondary details, meaning like some more wrinkles, trying to define better the muscles around the mouth and the cheeks, define some bone structures, and you know, just like trying to add a bit more detail to what I have, because I felt that the base, the proportions were like good enough. So I needed like more polygons to really start creating a few of these new features of the face. The lips and the mouth in this one, I think, came out like really nice compared to what I've been doing previously, because I tried the crease brush to recreate the lip sharpness shape. It's something I saw on some YouTube video of someone trying ZBrush or something, and I saw that I could apply the same thing to Blender, because previously I was just like using the clay builder brush mainly, and the what's it called, it's not the damn standard, but it's, you know, like the regular first brush. And yeah, after a while I just like decided that the generic alien was like too simple, so I just grabbed the snake hook brush and like extruded those large ear shapes that you saw just a few seconds ago. And I felt like, yeah, it looks kind of different, feels like very feline, like a cat. And then just like to keep the alien thing and not being it or not looking like an elf or something, I just like added those holes on the neck. So that's probably like his breathing system or something. And here you can add much more detail and texture if you add a texture to your brush. Just be sure that you have like a lot of geometry to work with. And the way you do it is just import any PNG image or TIFF image that is black and white. White means that it's gonna like extrude, and black means that it's gonna but it's the opposite of extrude. So just use like the regular damn standard brush and add texture where needed. At this point I turn off the symmetry to create a little bit of asymmetry and break up the perfection of the face. Just have different textures in different places. And once I felt it was good enough, I just went for the sculpt paint tool. It's not like the regular texture paint or anything, it's like the sculpt version of the painting tools. Because for some reason it performs like so much better than the regular texture painting, and this way I don't have to do an unwrap or anything. I just like paint as if I were sculpting. This is kind of similar to what ZBrush does. I went for some cool tones and decided to add a bit of redness in the cheeks and the nose and the lids, the ears and those holes that I previously mentioned, because that's like the areas where most blood would be like accumulating. And I then decided to add a little bit of texture of a pattern, creating some moles just with a darker color, like if it were the stripes of a tiger or something like that, to really make it feel like an alien creature that is like somehow rooted in something. So it's probably like some moles or something like that, some freckles even. So now I'm working on the material. I just plugged in the color attribute to the principal PSDF shader in the color socket. And something that's really cool of the version 4.0 or yeah, it's 4.0 of Blender is that the new principal PSDF has this new way of handling materials and handling the subdivision surface scattering. Sorry guys, really I am a little bit lost today. However, next one is coming really good and I didn't want to record this again. Anyway, hopefully you all understand. So I had some difficulties to really nail the texture because I was just plugging in an iris image that I got from the internet, and it was showing the corners of the white that are the limits of the image. You know, those trolling images that claim to be a PNG and they just have the white and gray squares in the background. So I just went into Photoshop that I had on a second screen and selected just the iris and then updated the texture in Blender. And now for the composition, for presentation, I just duplicated the sculpt. I didn't want to do any retop or anything, so I just instanced the bust. And to make it look a bit more dynamic, I masked the neck and just like rotated the neck just to make it feel a bit more natural and not posed in a symmetry way. And then when it comes to lighting, I came out with a very simple 3-point lighting setup. So it's a very soft light coming from top that is just like lighting the first alien, and the background character is just like in the shadows a bit more. It's just like a main light and then a fill light that is warmer on the left side of the screen, and then I just created another light coming from the back to create a bit of rim light and have some separation from the background, which in this case is black, but you will see me replace it with like a nice bokeh image. So here I'm playing with the depth of field of the camera. I am just like finding a nice format for the image and tweaking the lighting just a little bit more, see what works best, because I was losing a bit of of the detail that I had just sculpted, but at the same time I want to hide that it's not like a super high-res sculpt this time. So by now I am using this add-on called Photographer to really nail the focus, because I was already rendering and I saw that I was missing focus on the main character. So the add-on has like a special tool to create a focus plane in red, and you know where you are in focus and whatnot. So here in Photoshop I just created like a quick background. I imported my regular passes, which is the beauty and the ambient occlusion in this case, because it's like a very simple image. I used a cloud brush to paint some fog in the background, keep it very simple, trying a few LUTs and doing some color correction to really make the image come to life. One nice tip is to use the gradient filter, and finally some lens flares. Yeah, that I got probably from Photobasher or somewhere on the internet. And now using overlay to bring out light areas and darken the shadows, have some bloom in the background that I wanted, and then adding like a bokeh texture that really makes it feel much interesting than it really is, while keeping it very simple and focused on the main thing, which is the sculpt of these characters. And yeah, the subsurface scattering came out great in this image. It's working great in Blender 4.0. I really like it on the principal shader. And to finalize it, I just added some noise to the image, some chromatic aberration, and call it a day. So yeah, this was a really quick one, and I hope you liked it. Leave a comment to let me know what you want to see next, and subscribe, hit the like button, and see you next week with another video. Cheers, guys.